Good afternoon. My name is Ludo Waldman from the Center for Science and Technology Studies at Leiden University here in the Netherlands. And I'm, let's say, a scientometrician. I'm someone who studies science based on all kinds of data sources that inform us about what is going on in science. And data about scholarly outputs, publications, and other types of outputs is, of course, a key resource for people like me. And from that point of view, I would like to share with you my perspective on what CrossRef is doing. I will try in a kind of humble way to make some recommendations to CrossRef on what perhaps could be done in the future, could get more priority. I would like to start by something that, of course, you're all familiar with, and it was also mentioned by Catriona, Initiative for Open Citations. A development that has been very important for my community, for the scientometric community. So this is something you all know. It's nowadays almost 60% of the citations in CrossRef being open. That's a great development, something that scientometricians are very happy with. And indeed, we wrote this letter that Catriona also showed, this letter where we express our support for open citations, but in which we also explain why we feel this is important. So partly it is about enabling a larger community of researchers to do scientometric analysis. So having many more people worldwide being able to do scientometrics, to study how the science system is operating, to think about ways in which we can improve the system. Partly it is about improving the reproducibility of scientometric research. But this is also, for me, very much about applications of scientometrics, for instance, in research evaluation. Open citations is a way to make research evaluations more transparent. And in the end, that will lead, I believe, to more responsible ways of evaluating research based, for instance, on citation data. So I myself, one thing I'm doing is I'm developing a software tool. This software tool is called FOSViewer or VOS Viewer. It's a tool for creating visualizations of science based on bibliographic data, data about scientific outputs and in particular scientific publications. And I want to show you the thing we made. I did that together with my colleague, Nation van Eck, and what we made is support for working with CrossRef data in our software tool. So in the tool you have something like this. You can query CrossRef interactively. And then through the API of CrossRef, all the relevant bibliographic data is downloaded and you are then able to create all kinds of visualizations, network visualizations based on that data. So here we are searching for publication in a journal, Scientometrics, from the past 10 years. And then, for instance, we can get a visualization of a co-authorship network. So the researchers publishing in this journal and all their collaborative relationships. This is another possibility. You could create a citation network. This is the citation network of scientific journals based on all the citation links that we could get from CrossRef. This is hundreds of millions of citation links. So we got all these citations through the API. We made the journal citation network and then we visualized it. And then you get this. So we see in the top, we see biological journals, medical journals. At the right, you see physics journals, chemistry journals. In the bottom left, you see social science journals. This is something that we could make, but this is something that anyone can make because this is open data in CrossRef. And I believe it's a great development that over the past 2 years, this has become possible thanks to CrossRef, but also, of course, thanks to all the publishers that have made this possible. It's really great. And to show you how happy I am with this, let me show you a picture of myself. Yeah. So as a professor, you sometimes need to wear these strange things, and I don't like that. But to make a bit of fun and feel more at ease, I carry with me 500 million of citation links. And, well, this is my way of showing basically how much I value what all of you have been doing over the past 2 years. It's really, really very important and a great development. So now, let me go to some things that I think deserve attention. Sometimes I learned over the past 2 years there are technical problems related to the core infrastructure provided by CrossRef. For instance, we have this under-reporting of matched references. So there was a problem in the citation links that we could get through the API. Citation links were missing. I must say, this was a bit disappointing. So you make these nice visualizations, then you find out that a significant number of citation links are missing. Of course, you want this data to be reliable. That's important. This is something at Etherite, something that happened more recently. So problems with the API, querying, searching for titles of articles, some technical problem, which now, for instance, means that users of my software tool, FossViewer, are unable to do to search based on titles of articles. They will get some error message. It doesn't work. So that's another problem of another illustration of problems with the infrastructure. There are a few more like inconsistencies between XML and JSON output, all quite technical things, but things that I believe should really be addressed. We all, of course, want to have full confidence in what we get out of the APIs. That's important. Another thing is this: Bianca Kramer, who's not in the room, but she is here at this event. She helped me to make this slide. Bianca Kramer collected some statistics on the availability of abstracts in Crossref. This is probably not a surprise for most of you. So when we look at journal articles in the past 3 years, we see that we have abstracts only for 15% of these journal articles. So most of you, most of the publishers, do not yet deposit abstracts in Crossref. And I believe that's a pity, because there's so much value in these abstracts. It's like the citations, it's equally important. The abstracts are, for instance, important to do proper information retrieval. We need to have them, and also the content of publishers will, of course, benefit from this. It will become more easy to discover. So this is something where I hope Crossref, working together with publishers, can make steps in improving the situation, in improving the completeness of metadata. So these are some publishers that are making abstracts available, at least for a certain share of their content in Crossref, the bigger publishers. But there are also many big publishers not in this chart, so they don't make abstracts available. And I hope we can all work together to improve this situation. It's, as I already mentioned, it is as important as the citation data. And also, if we don't do this, something else is going to happen. What you see over here is the same publications, the same journal articles from the past 3 years, and now we see how abstracts can be obtained, not from Crossref, but from The Lens, which you may know is a website and a database that also makes all kinds of bibliographic data available. It's to a large extent based on Microsoft Academic Graph. So Microsoft is crawling the web, and they find many different versions of the same article. And if one of these versions has an abstract, that's what they take, and that's what they make available. So we see 60% of abstracts can be obtained from The Lens. So basically, if we don't solve this problem in a kind of neat, properly organized way through Crossref, then it is going to be solved in a kind of more messy and unorganized way, for instance, by Microsoft, by The Lens. I would prefer the more structured, the more clean solution. So that's another point. I really hope that here Crossref, together with all of you, can make step forwards. And then we have all these nice initiatives. I have learned more and more about all of this. I believe this is all very important, very nice work. You know, of course, about these initiatives. I don't need to tell you anything about it. Well, there is this ROAR initiative, Research Organizations Registry. That one, I believe, is in particular important. So you all know that we have this big problem of university rankings being so dominant in our research system. Many universities basing their important decisions, their policies, to a significant extent on how they perform in the rankings. It depends a bit on the country, but in many countries we have this issue. And this is a problem in itself. And then on top of that, we have the problem of these rankings being non-transparent. It's really not clear how they are produced, how the data is obtained, whether the data is reliable. So many of these rankings produce bibliometric statistics, citation statistics, but we don't know how they actually define the organizations, the universities, how they link publications to these universities. It's all a black box. And that's really a big problem when you realize how much depends on these university rankings. So ROAR potentially could solve a problem like that, could make these rankings more transparent, could enable all of us to debate whether or not we like these statistics that the rankings present, could also enable more people to develop alternative types of statistics so that we can also have discussions about different ways of looking at the performance of universities. This is all important. This is also very difficult. At my center, we are doing this already for 2 decades. Linking publications to organizations, to universities, it's extremely challenging. It takes a lot of resources if you want to do it carefully. So that's also something that we need to be aware of. And that brings me to my 3 recommendations. So the first one is perhaps the most important one. Make sure your basic infrastructure is working well. So that's the recommendation I want to make to Crossref. The second one, work together with publishers to increase completeness of metadata. This should really be a collaborative effort, and I hope that can be realized. So I showed you the abstracts, but of course, the same point can be made for the affiliations, for license data, and so on. And the third one, for Crossref, participate in initiatives for improving and enriching metadata, but also, and that's of course the other side, we need to think about developing fair models for funding and sustaining these initiatives. So I mentioned this building such a research organization registry. If you want to do it properly, it is a big effort and it takes a significant amount of resources. And I think it's a fair question to ask how that should be funded, how that should be sustained. And I hope we can also have discussions about that today and tomorrow. Thank you.